One thing I'd like to look at is the average number of minutes students spend in the classroom during their first week. Right now, I have a bunch of engagement records for different students, and they're not in any particular order. First, I'd like to separate out the engagement records into groups, where each group contains all the engagement records for a particular student. I'll represent these groups using a dictionary, where the keys are student account keys, and the values are lists of engagement records for that student. Next, I'll compute the total number of minutes spent in the classroom by each student by summing up the number of minutes in each engagement record for that student. Finally, I'll compute the average of the totals to get the answer I'm looking for. Now I'll show you the code I used to solve this problem. First, I created the dictionary I mentioned to group engagement data by the account key. You can see that I used a default dict here instead of a vanilla dictionary. If you haven't seen Python's default dict before, that's okay. It allows you to specify a default value. In this case, I've specified list. That means if I ever try to look up a key in the dictionary and that key is not there, I'll get the empty list instead. You'll see how this will be helpful in a minute. Then I looped through each engagement record and saved the account key in this variable. Next, I looked up the list of engagement records for that account key. Here's where the default dict comes in handy. If I had never added that account key yet, then I get the empty list. Then I append this engagement record to the list of engagement records for that account key. Next, I wanted to add up the number of minutes visited by each account, and I decided to save that in this dictionary. So this dictionary will store a number for each account key instead of a list of engagement records. Next, I looped over the dictionary I created previously, and by looping over the dot items, I got both the key and the value for each entry in the dictionary. For each account, the number of minutes starts as 0. Next, I loop over each engagement record in the list of engagement records for that student. And I add the number of minutes that student visited in that engagement record to the total number of minutes for the student. Finally, I store that number of minutes under that account key in the new dictionary. Now I'm ready to take the average of those totals, and for that the account keys are no longer relevant. I'm just interested in the numbers themselves. So I'll use the .values method to get out just the values from that dictionary. Now I could calculate the mean by hand, but instead I'm going to use a library called NumPy to do it. You'll be seeing a lot of NumPy later in this course, and I've imported it using the line import NumPy as np. Adding as np allows me to later refer to the NumPy library as np instead of referring to it as NumPy. It's just a little shorter and easier to type. You don't have to do this, but lots of code posted online will have this convention, so it's good to have seen it before. Then I can take the mean by calling np.mean and passing in the total minutes. And I see that the average number of minutes spent was 647. I'm interested in knowing more than just the mean here, though. I'd also like to know what's the standard deviation, what's the minimum, and what's the maximum. It turns out NumPy has functions to calculate those as well. They're np.std, np.min, and np.max. Now, you might know that Python actually also has a min and max function that you can use without importing the NumPy library. You'll learn later why you might want to use NumPy's version instead, but for now I'm just going to go ahead and use it since I've already imported the library. And when I run this, I see that the standard deviation is pretty large, larger than the mean, the minimum is 0, and the maximum is about 10,000 minutes. That's a huge maximum, and in fact, there's got to be a problem here, because when you calculate it out, that's actually slightly more than the total number of minutes in 1 week. So, something has gone wrong.